So here I have just started this background calibration, and just like earlier I selected the background calibration, and then by doing the sequence of next, and finally this wizard came, and after plate keeping the plate in the holder and starting the machine, I just pressed the start run button, and now you can see like this, it will show the calibration is happening, or the background calibration. Oh, the background calibration is still going on. So finally, it shows that the background calibration has passed. You can see here, there is an analysis report. It is showing that the background calibration has passed, and again, we just have to take out the plate, not the machine. And let's finish. This is all done. Take off the plate and always put the plate on its cover. Do not put this calibration plate anywhere else. Close. And likewise, I will do this optical calibration, dye calibration, and NSP calibration. So now select this optical calibration. Once we select the optical calibration, then go to the start calibration. It shows the instruction plate, and then again with all these following these instructions. ROI background optical dye instrument verification. Select the next. So we are going to use that ROI calibration plate here. The next. Next. And then next. So from here we'll just start the run. Now it is showing that the optical calibration has also passed. And this is the hall lab. So now just take out the plate. And this is done, and optical calibration is passed now. So just click next and press finish, and here it will show the update. Like today is 4th December, so the next calibration should be done before 4th June 2020. So this calibration is valid for 6 months. Now again, just unload the tray, take out the plate, and again, do not put these plates, calibration plates, anywhere else. always put, keep these plates on their packing. So once this optical calibration is done, now we will go for this die calibration. And here in this die calibration, we will see here there are two options. One is at system die calibration and another is the custom die calibration. So it is preferred to go with the system die calibration, and here you can select the type of die which is of your interest. So normally in this calibration kits, different plates for different dies come, and you can select any die. So for each die we have the individual plate. So likewise, I will just first select this CY3 die, and then by pressing this calibration button, this calibration will start. So I have just selected this CY3 die, and now I will take out the plate with the CY3 die. So here this is the kit from Applied Biosystem, and this is the catalog number 4362201. And this kit has a real-time PCR system spectral calibration kit, second, and it is a fast 96 well kit, and it has a die plates for die CY3, CY5, Texas red die. So I'll just take out this CY3. Let's see what it is. CY3 die. So I just keep it here, and rest I'll just put back into the fridge. Let's see. So this is at die calibration plate, and this plate is having the CY3 die solution, and I'm just keeping this plate here in this block. Push the block. Like this, and start calibration. And show next calibrate. Here I'm just CY3. Run. And so the status like this. So this CY3 error is passed, and likewise we can just select various dies and we can do this calibration for different dies. Finish calibrating CY3 die. So it is done. So here it is showing the status of CY3. You can see that today on 4th December we have just calibrated the system for CY3 die, and this CY5 is expired or about to expire on. No, it is already expired. So now the next turn will be to do the CY5. So from here we detail I will see this, select the CY5, and here this is the plate for this CY5 die. I have just taken out the plate, and again the block is open, and we'll do the same exercise again. So after 5 minutes at room temperature, I'm just keeping this plate here. This is the CY5 plate, and push it, and from here just start calibration. And next, and select this CY5. Here the masses, the system will start. Now the system has started, and you can see in use. So it will just update the data. Now collecting data, and you can see the data collection has started. This is also done, CY5. Next. It is fast. Next. And finish calibrating CY5. So like this, all the dies can be calibrated. So this can be followed for all the dies, and then just keep calibrating. And I'm just stopping this video now. So the procedure is same. So this is all about that calibration of this ABI ABI 7500 fast real-time system. So this is how the calibration is done, and keep following. You will find some new videos also on different instruments, and just comment how do you find this video. Is it helpful, or is it informative, or some improvement is needed?